Kokazari today, which is a long board which has pretty much all of the implements that we need to make tea for you, except for the tea itself and the tea bowl. Can you hear me? Yes? Okay. And may I introduce myself? My name is Keiko, and I have a wonderful group of students who are assisting and being hosts, and hopefully we will serve you good tea today. So we begin by looking at the theme of today's tea, which is baika, goku o hiraku in Japanese. And it translates to when the plum blossoms are in bloom, we invite the five happinesses into our lives. The five happinesses being long life, wealth, good health, virtuous living, and living our given life to its fullest. So this is our wish for everyone today. And we have a very simple flower arrangement, which is a camellia. It's a local product given to us by one of the wonderful volunteers, Doris Asano, here at the garden, as well as the Matsuri. And so we would like to begin by serving you the sweets. As you know, you will, if you would, please bow back when you are bound to. That is our greeting. The pink mochi is strawberry flavored, and the white is a regular kyuki or mochi, plain rice flavor. Our palate for the tea that sometimes can be bitter, although I don't think today's is that bitter since it's freshly opened and freshly ground. Have you all had the matcha before? Yes? Been here before to our presentation perhaps? No? Yes? No? I'm glad you're here. And once everyone has received their sweets, our host will be coming out to greet you, so please bow when she gives you a bow. She will say, Ippoku sashiagemasu, which is, I will humbly serve you tea. And the host will actually bid you to have your sweets at a later portion of the ceremony itself, so please wait until at that time. Thank you. as the first guest and second and third guest have done, hold the fruit and then proceed in pocket. Normally the left one, because that is reserved for things that have been used. So when you are invited to a tea next time, you will know what you do if you're wearing this or if you're wearing these two clothes like this. Raise the bowl to select an appreciation like this, if you would do that, and then turn it two quarters to the right, with the right hand on your left hand. So on the left and then turn on the right. So you've done that, that's fine, and then anchor it this way. On the front is probably better anchored, and then please finish the two here. Everyone will receive their own card. Is made locally by a local pot, so please enjoy the tea. And for those who are interested, we do offer classes here once a month at the Japanese Friendship Garden. So I will take questions on that afterwards if you are so inclined to do. Of Japanese decorum, etiquette, cultural learning, calligraphy, all the arts, and basic, how should we treat each other? We can learn this in Japanese tea ceremony. Our philosophy that we try to achieve on our daily basis is wake seijaku. Wa meaning harmony. Ke is respect. That's the core of our beliefs for each other, for nature, for everything that we are in relationship with. Say is purity, so purity of heart and mind, body. And then lastly is jaku, which is tranquility. So out of practicing the first three tenets or principles, hopefully our peace lies within as well. using a closing bowl, which you will place cold water in as a symbol of final purification of the tea bowl. Ceremony within the tea ceremony that we do to build the fire itself. Today we are not able to do that, so we are kind of symbolizing that we will be able to do charcoal in case we need to do it. And everything being, there are essentially three parts to a tea ceremony. Of course, the initial purification to show respect for our guests that we are cleansing everything, although everything has been cleansed before. And the second part, of course, is drinking. And the final portion is replenishing and closing everything as they were originally. So we may be prepared for perhaps unexpected guests. So the pot is always boiling, always welcoming as a message of hospitality to those who pass through our doors. Examining when you are leaving a tea space. the first place you would inspect is the tokonoma, and the first space that you would look at when you're coming in is normally the tokonoma, because that is the highest ranking part of any room or tea space. So starting with the first guest, if you would like to do that, here and inspect the utensils if you